Here now are seven things to know to start your day. Number one, happening now, voters in Dixville Notch, the first to cast their ballots in the New Hampshire primaries when the polls opened at midnight. The latest polls show Bernie Sanders and Pete Buttigieg competing for the top spot. Democrats want to avoid the meltdown that happened at the Iowa caucus, where a partial re-canvass is still underway.
Number two, apparently the biggest rally in the state of New Hampshire last night was not for a Democratic candidate. It was actually for President Donald Trump. He held a rally to overflow crowds in Manchester just last night. After his remarks, the president flew to Dover Air Force Base to participate in the dignified transfer of the remains of two soldiers killed recently in Afghanistan.
Number three, and new this morning, the Philippines notified the U.S. it intends to end a major security pact allowing American forces to train in that country in the most serious threat to their treaty alliance under the country's current president. The foreign secretary said in a tweet, Manila's notice of termination of the visiting forces agreement was received by the deputy chief of mission at the U.S. embassy in Manila. He refused to provide other details on the drastic step as a, quote, diplomatic courtesy.
And number four, a U.S. soldier could face 20 years in prison for distributing instructions on how to make a bomb. Jarrett William Smith pleaded guilty Monday to disseminating the information on social media. The 24-year-old is scheduled to be sentenced on May 18th.
Number five, the Department of Justice believes four members of the Chinese military were behind one of the largest hacks in U.S. history. The 2017 breach of Equifax affected millions of Americans. Equifax says it is spending more than $1 billion to now enhance security and technology to protect your data.
And number six, the Pentagon says the number of U.S. service members diagnosed with traumatic brain injuries has gone up to more than 100. This after the Iranian ballistic missile attack early last month in Iraq. 109 military members have been treated so far for mild TBI. Most have returned to duty.
At number seven, temperatures right around 30 degrees this morning to kind of kick things off for your Tuesday. The calm before the storm. We'll talk about the timing of that next winter storm, how much snow we're going to get, and just how cold it will be to follow.